economic crisis. This is either the real thing or it's another shadow. Did you see what's happened in the Mideast this week? That we would see Arab nations coming in agreement with Israel and saying, let's not just have peace, let's do business together. When you see these things begin to happen, look up, for your redemption draws nigh. We are right at the door of the Sabbath millennium. The reason for hearing the footsteps of the Messiah is to wake us up. That's the reason. This Friday, something is about to happen. We are days away from either the shadow or the real thing. You don't want to miss the rapture, but you don't want to miss the revival either. Wake up. What's happening is never happened before, ever. There'll be those who will say, people have been saying that for 2,000 years. They also said Israel would never become a nation again. This Friday, Rosh Hashanah, is a shadow of the rapture. The Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some count slackness, but is long-suffering towards us, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. They're waking up. Guys, this is God saying, wake up. Something is about to happen. Why are people turning off the sports and turning on Christian television? People are starting to say, you know what? I better wake up. I better make sure that I'm finding out what God is doing. That's the reason for all of this. Because God is such a wonderful God. He doesn't want any of us to miss on the blessing that comes before the judgment. The rapture is God's judgment on the church. And he said, look what's happening to your world without me. You're throwing me out of your school. You're throwing me out of the government. You're throwing me out of the church. This Friday, either our new year begins in heaven or our new year begins here on earth. I want you to understand. I want you to hear that shofar blowing. On Rosh Hashanah, God opens the book.